All right, the next match is going to be Ray Robles versus Ken Thomason. It's a race to one pocket, winner's side match. I'll find out the handicap for the match in a second. Looks like Ray is giving up 8-7-9-7, so it would be 9-7 on Ray's break and 8-7 on Ken's break. It's a race of two, one pocket, live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Ken has the first break, so it's 8-7. Ken should tell Ray, hey, I'll take 9-7 on my break. That's a pretty interesting break. It looks like he hit the last ball there. Turned out pretty nice, actually. I don't think he really left anything. I don't know if Ray can bank the 10 ball. Ken is the former owner of Hard Time Billiards in California. Ray is a pretty solid player here in Phoenix area. Plays all the games well. Solid all-around player. Plays a good straight pull, one pocket. He's trying to go off the edge of this three and then into the stack. No. Well, good shot here for Ken would be to go thin off this 10 ball. It's the one closest to the rail here. Go thin off that and then onto the stack with a cue ball. You know, just a traditional shot. Real simple, but really effective. He likes to bank the three ball, get it close to his hole, and put the cue ball up table. Not a bad shot either. You know, I don't know, Ray's looking for a dead ball here. Always good to look at the stack and see if you got something laying good. Thank you. Yeah, Ray might bank out this 10 ball. I mean, it's total free shot. If he makes it, he might get more balls. He might graze the 13. Oh, he elected to play the 13 ball and get his cue ball safe. Not a bad shot at all, because hasn't left anything for Ken, but Ken's in a funny position here.
I have corn dogs and french fries ready at the bar.
I mean, he might have to shoot straight into this these two balls and put his cue ball up. Yeah, that was tough action there. And Ray's going to come to the table with a combination. 5-12 combination. Now, if Ray doesn't want to shoot it, he could 2-rail the 9 ball and freeze him to the 3 ball. But he's going to shoot the combination. Ray's a very good ball striker. He pockets balls well, so. Not an easy table layout. Go from the 5 to the 7 ball. This game is 8-7. That's the handicap involved, and Ray has 3 balls so far. He didn't get a rail, now he's got 2. This is a tricky situation here for Ken. I mean, he could bank the 2 and go up table. He could try to twist in the 8. Or he can 2-rail the 8 out of there and leave the cue ball on the end rail. How you doing? Too slow? Thank you. We're live from Bull Shooters in Phoenix, Arizona. I appreciate all of you guys tuning in to the monthly One Pocket. Enjoy the stream. In a little bit of a funny position here. He has three balls. Looks like he's going to go off the four and try to freeze onto those two balls or go down onto them. Yeah. You know, Ken's got a good shot here if he wants to fire this two ball in and slide over with a cue ball. I mean, that's... He's got to do something offensive soon. The ball's, I mean, this is a great opportunity. If he can pop this ball and slide over. He elected to go forward. You know, Ray's a shooter. Ray might try to pocket the three ball. I don't necessarily like it, though. Might get Ken off to the races here. Better shot just to move the two ball, in my opinion. Get this two ball out of there. I elected to go off the 13. Uh-oh. Ken does have a shot here on the two ball. You find him a bridge. Everybody, I gotta leave you. I gotta play a match, so enjoy this one.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
We now have brownies ready at the bar. Brownies ready at the bar. And don't forget our $2 tamales, jalapeno cheddar with, or jalapeno cheddar and red beef tamales and red chili burritos. Thank you.
All right, guys, it's Lenny. I'm back on the mic. You're watching Ken Thomason at the table. He's playing Ray Robles. The handicap is 9787. That's what Ken is getting. 9-7 on Ray's break and 8-7 on his break. I just got finished with my match, so I'm able to join you guys and be around. It looks like he was trying to move that eight, shoot the two and the eight. Two somehow got past the eight ball and straight into the hole. And Ray's got a good chance here to run some balls. I believe Ray needs... I want to say four or five from here. That's pretty much where he's at.
Hey, what's up? Yeah?
You don't save any of them, do you?
Sometimes, no, sometimes I'll save them.
You should have saved when we were playing, you know what I mean? With the black
yeah.
Shirt,
you could see what we, you know. Yeah, so, I mean, I save some, I can only save so many to the server, but sometimes yeah. I record them to the hard drive. If somebody, like, is on the stream and they want their match, yeah. tell me, I can record it to the hard drive and then...
And put it on a DVD,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
yeah, that's what me and the junior were saying. If we're playing,
yeah.
do it, we'll pay you for it, you know. Just
yeah, that way you guys can have
I like
yeah.
to see what I'm doing right. I know I'm doing a lot wrong, but I like to see what I'm...
Doing right, too, right?
Yeah.
See them both, yeah. Yeah, it's easy to forget what you did.
Yeah.
Right? After the match is over, you forget what happened.
Yeah. How's the audio and video out there for everybody watching? We are live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Appreciate you all stopping by. Cool. Glad to hear, guys. Cut that, and Ken's going to come to the table. Not sure if he can bank this ball or not. If not, he'll just take it out of there. But it looks like he's trying to hit it with a little inside and then bank it and come down. And he did. How did he hit it? Ooh, pretty close. Well, he got it close to the pocket. He's left Ray in a funny spot here. You might see Ray try to shoot this three ball. Just got to be careful of the scratch in the side if he does attempt it. He's a straight shooter. That was a nice shot. And now, if he wants to just give him this ball, he can. Otherwise, he can try to spin behind it and kick it out of there. Thank you. I hope you're all doing good this weekend. I want to urge you guys to go and check out this link. I'm about to put it up on the screen in a second. Go to goplaypool.com and pool together for Hunter Cole, who's in a battle for cancer. Loves pool. If you can help out, that would be great. Check it out, goplaypool.com. Ken's got another bank here. See how he hits it. Oh, he wins that cue ball to slow up. It did. Put Ray in a funny little position here. I don't think Ray's going to back up the 12. He's probably going to have to shoot the 12 into the 4. And, well, I mean, that's the 8 ball, I believe. Is it? No, it's the 4 ball. Okay, yeah, he's going to try to shoot the 12 into the 4, probably, and move those balls. You know, funny things can happen here, you know. There's no, you have a general idea of where they're going, but. Oh, that worked out pretty good, huh? Ken bank the 12 if he wants to shoot that shot. If he wants to get a little aggressive. But it was a good chance that he could leave a shot for Ray if he doesn't make it. Good shot. He's left Ray kind of jacked up here. Kind of a tricky ball to move from this position. Sometimes, you know, when it gets a little funny, you're almost better off giving him the ball than trying to do something crazy and, you know, or that's real touchy and end up scratching or selling out. Oh, it was a pretty good shot. A double kiss happens a lot when the ball's close to the pocket, and people will think it's lucky that you got a double kiss, but I mean, many times you're going to play the double kiss to move the ball away from the pocket. Oh. Well, Ray's going to have a back cut. He hit that a little full. Good shot. I think Ray might just need this one ball. This game, he's giving 9-7, so he needs one more. I want to say Ken got the first game, so he's leading 1-0. If Ray can make this bank, he would tie it up. And it looks like he hit it really good. Yep. Well, we got a hill match here, it looks like, between these two gentlemen. And I believe it's Ken's break, so Ken will be getting 8-7 this game. Quite sure, to be honest with you. I'm just glad that he stopped by to grace us with his presence and play a little one pocket. Ken's got a good chance to make this bank here and get his cue ball over behind the balls. A little bit of left-handed English. He hits it pretty well. Good shot. And Ken's got a control of the table here, and you know he wants to limit Ray's movement when Ray gets back to the table, because I don't think Ken has a shot on anything that goes, but he wants to move some balls over to his side and preferably freeze Ray to a ball, and don't let him have too many options for what he can do next. That's good. He got the ball close. Well, Ray's in a funny spot here. I'm not sure if he can hit the 10 ball. If he can hit the 10, maybe he can go off the 10 and make that ball. And either way, he's got to do something there. Gonna be tough. Well, he did hit it, but could not make it. Now, if Ken wants to get crafty and not shoot this ball, I like actually banking the 10 ball over into the 3 and sliding my cue ball up and just, you know, waiting for a better opportunity. But Ken elected to shoot now, and he got the one ball, but now he's kind of lost his stranglehold on the game, and he's going to have to probably cross the 10. Maybe, I don't know if the 10 can get past the 3, but if not, maybe bank it into the 3 and get your cue ball up. I like that shot. See, he played his cue ball up and got a ball over by his hole. It's got Ray in trouble again. Ken is leading 2-0. This game, Ray is giving Ken 8-7, so Ken only needs 5 more balls. That was a pretty good shot. It worked out well for Ray. Now again, Ken wants to protect this 2 ball, which is close to his pocket. He could use the 11 ball and float up table. Or you can go very thinly off to 6, but you don't want to scratch in that top right-hand corner pocket. Elected to pocket it. Now Ray is looks like he's gonna try to kick up the 2 ball. Probably lightly. I don't know if this combination is shootable. I mean, he might shoot the 14-4, and he might be able to slide over behind the balls with the cue ball. That's what he's shooting. I think he's got a shot on the five, but he's jacked up. Not an easy shot. But his cue will be going to those balls, and, you know, a good chance he'll get another shot after he makes the five. But you got to make the five ball first, you know? Well, it looks like he can cue somewhat okay. Oh, boy. That's going to cost him. That is going to cost him. I like Ken making the eight and maybe falling down on the combination if it lays good. Well, he's got a three ball combination, it looks like. Not without risk. Oh. Well, he didn't come out far enough. He just clipped that seven ball, and it slowed down the cue ball. If he didn't clip it, I think he would have been okay. Now he's got a decision to make here. Do you try to get crazy and cut the seven? I don't think he can reach it, and it's real paper-thin hit. I mean, he could try this bank here and draw his cue ball back. You got to draw the cue ball back down to this rail. You don't want to let him have a shot on the five. Unless you could slide over. How'd he hit it? Ooh. Close.
Sure, actually. I can look it up. Let's see. Yeah, same time. 2:32.
Ken missed that ball. That was an unexpected miss from Ken. And it looks like Ken has five balls. He only needs... He only needs two, I believe. Only good thing for Ken is the balls aren't really laying that good for Ray. That ball, and looks like Ken has a bank on the 11 if he wants to get on. If not, he can cross it over to his side and run his cue ball down to the bottom rail near the 5 and 7 ball. Looks like he can see enough of the nine to bank it. Got to be careful here. Yeah, that's... Oh, boy. Oh, boy. He got very fortunate there to make that ball. And, you know, he wasn't going for that, but sometimes you get a little fortunate, and you got to take advantage of that. Don't feel bad. Just close it out. And that should be it. That's the match. Good match there. We'll have another one up for you guys in a few. So hang out. Thanks for stopping by and watching OnTheRailTV.com. We're live from Bullshooters in Phoenix, Arizona. Great room. I think it's the biggest room in Phoenix. I want to urge you guys to go to GoPlayPool.com. Pool together for Hunter Cole. Trying to help him out in his battle against cancer. So appreciate you guys stopping by and tuning in. We'll have a match for you guys shortly. Stay tuned in, guys. I might just move the camera to the other table that's near us so you guys can watch it. Looks like we're going to have Ray Robles playing Jody Villegas, I believe is the last name. She is our only female player in the tournament. She likes to come in and play with